Hi everyone, this is Sumita. So the topic that we are going to see today is about broken links. How we will be checking broken links and what is the need to check broken links. First let us see what is the need to check a broken link and what does it mean. So let us give an URL called google1234.com. If you see, it says that this site cannot be reached because this link is not correct. Whereas you can also take it like, if you have a link like this and if you click it, it will not go to the correct page. So now why we want to check the broken links? You go to the page called Google. Here whatever you have as Gmail, images, sign in, everything is a link. So in this page you can see 30 to 40 links. Here even about business, all these are link. If you click about, for example, it goes to a link. So this is the link for about. Likewise, you will be having multiple links inside Google. So in order to see what are links you have, just give inspect. So in inspect you can see, for example, you want to click I'm feeling lucky, can do an inspect, and here you will be having this input, right? Okay, let us take another example, Gmail, which has an URL attached. So here if you see this href, in this href you are having the URL for Gmail. So this will be available in a tag under A, and this is called an attribute. So for any of the link that you have, you will be having a reference URL that is attached. So if you are going to click a link, any of the link, it should actually take you to a different page and it should not say that page is not found. So as I was saying, if you click advertising, it should go to this page, right? It shouldn't say page not found. If it gives like page not found, 404 forbidden page, any such error, then it means that link, that advertising link is not working, and you are supposed to check like why this link is not working. Oh, in a normal scenario, for a page like Google, you can even take Amazon or whatever web page, you can see that there are multiple links available and all links should work fine. If it is not working, then you have to verify why the problem is. So through manual verification, it is not possible to check all these links. So for that reason, we are having a program in Selenium called broken links. Now let us go into the program. Already you know how to create a driver and then how to assign and how to open a Chrome driver. For this example, I am planning to take redbus.in page. So I will be going to this page and check how many broken links are there. Now if you see, you can see find elements. So far you might have used mostly find element. There will not be an S attached. Here you are using find elements. The reason is that when you are giving by dot tag name of A, you will be having multiple elements. Okay, that is the reason you are giving it inside find elements. Now if you see, for example, images will inspect, you can see that it is under the tag name A, right? Likewise, you will be having lot of elements under tag name A. Even Gmail, you select, it will be under a tag name A. Inside tag name A only, usually you will have this URL for any of the link. Okay, so in order to check the broken link, we have to take all the URLs which is available within the tag name A in the page that we are going to open. So here what you are doing? You are opening redbus.in, for example. there you are say giving find elements by tag name A. That this will give how many elements are available, that this link object will have a size because it is a list. If you take the size of it, it will show how many tag names with A are there. Now if you browse through or if you go through one by one, you can take each of the link. Now we saw that the attribute is href. When we are seeing, you saw that the attribute is href. So this is tag name and this is attribute. Class is an attribute, href is an attribute. Likewise, there are multiple attributes. So for href, whatever value comes, that will be the URL, as we have seen. So now what you are saying, you are giving like link URL is equal to, you are first taking the first tag, okay, with A, and in that you are saying for that element you are asking get attribute with the name href. Because if you just say get attribute, it might get the attribute for class or for href, or if it is more than that, it will show. So you are giving that you need the attribute value for href. Once you get that attribute for href, that is nothing but the URL. Right, now we have to check whether the URL, all the links inside the URL is working. Once that is checked, we'll print that all links are checked. Now let us see the program to verify the URL. First thing, Java has a class by name URL. If you just browse, you can see that there is a class name by name URL. So URL represents uniform resource locator. You all know what an URL is. So for working with an URL, Java has a class by itself. So if you are having if you want to know more about URL, you can just go through this to see what it means. Now you have to create an object for this URL. For that you should give the link URL, which is nothing but the string that we are passing. So for the first URL you are checking, right? So you are passing that URL, and that passing that value, you create an object. Then you have to have a URL connection object. So URL connection with support for HTTP. Each HTTP URL connection instance is used to make a single request, okay? So this HTTP URL connection is to establish a connection to that particular URL. You create an object for that and you say URL.open connection. This is nothing but this object, okay, dot open connection, and it should be of type HTTP URL connection, so you are typecasting it. So this will open a connection for that particular URL, and that data is available in this object. Now with this object you can work on that URL. First thing is you are giving dot set connect timeout. So how long should the link, this one, wait for that URL to open? Okay, sometimes you might know that a particular web page might take more time to load. If it is not loading within 3 seconds, it doesn't mean that the page is not working. Sometimes we ourselves know, when you are working in a project, we will know that this web page will take more time to load because of database connectivity or whatsoever. So in that case you can give more time here. So this is connection timeout. The time that you give, it will wait for that till that time, and then it will say that it's unable to connect, and this time is in milliseconds. Okay, so it is given here in milliseconds. After you set the connection timeout, you call the connect method. So connect method is to connect to that URL. Now once you connect to the URL, you can get multiple responses for that. So if you see the details for connect URL, it is to connect with an URL, and you will be able to connect successfully if you get a response code of 200. Okay, so if you see the response code details, you can see a status of 200 means okay, a status of 401 means unauthorized. Likewise, you can have multiple status for as a response when you connect to that URL. So now how we have checked this, if it is 200, then we say that response code is okay, right? So okay also we are getting get response code, okay, and the response message. There is another type of response that is called HTTP not found. It is that web page is not available. Okay, for that you use this, and that also we can see. And any other response that you get apart from 200, that can be say even this is not a valid response, but you wanted to particularly capture, okay, for HTTP not found. So I have given just an example here. Likewise, if you want, you can type give, or we can directly say except for 200, anything else, the response might be an error. That response message and the code, we will be getting it. Fine. And whenever you create this object, it can throw an exception. In order to catch that exception, you have to put it in a try catch. Now let us run this program. It is opening red bus and it is actually checking all the URL, the back end. You can see that in the console. So see here, the total links are 115. So it means that you have in the redbus.in page itself, you have 115 links. Manually, when we are doing a testing, it is not possible for you to check all the 115 links, click it and see whether it is working fine or not. That's the reason this broken links is very important. Here, it is not at over, it is 115. So let us just see what the response. There is a response here 404. One is 301. There is another response. Okay. See, there is a bad gateway 502. So if you see in this Redbus page, there are some might be some 10 URL. See here, moved permanently 301. So some 5 to 10 URL which is not working fine. The blog and all is moved permanently, right? Hence, if you get this report, the user will know or the administrator will know that there are certain URL inside the web page that is actually not working as expected. Red char is not found. Okay, this is not found. Okay, all these are response from the HTTP. And here it is moved permanently, is 301, right? 502 means bad gateway. So all this, if you see, it is not correct one, right? So you can write a program. Even instead of printing it in a console, I have given like print this output in a console. You can print it in an Excel file. For example, you can say that whichever quote response is correct, you print in one sheet. Whichever response is not okay, you print in another sheet. Okay, error. You call that sheet as error and print it in that. Now, after this program runs, you can see that working code out of this 115 link, whichever is working, whichever has the response code of 200 will be in one sheet, and whichever is having an error, that is some 10 of them, right, they will be in another sheet. So you can just share this detail to say that these links are not working, so that they will just check on those links. So it is not possible, and it is very difficult to do this testing manually. And hence, we are doing this broken link. So, try this program, go through it, and if you have any doubt or clarification, put it in the comment section so that we can discuss. Thank you. Nandri.